The Maharashtra government cleared an anti-superstition and black magic ordinance bill today, the first of its kind in the country. The bill had been pending in the assembly for 8 years, and this development took place only after the murder of the renowned rationalist in Pune. Dr. Narendra Dabholkar had relentlessly campaigned for such a law, which had drawn strong criticism from right-wing groups who had called him anti-Hindu.
It took the death, the brutal murder of this man, for the Maharashtra government to finally act. A day after renowned rationalist Dr. Narendra Dabholkar, who spent 30 years fighting superstition and black magic, was shot dead in Pune. Today, the cabinet cleared the draft of the anti-superstition and black magic bill to turn it into an ordinance.
If some normal citizen is spending his life and investing in lives of thousands of people to stand for a cause and a reason, the government has to make these people feel secure.
A first in the country, the ordinance, originally drafted by Dr. Dabholkar, promises criminal action against those godmen who exploit innocent people, who claim to have divine powers and that they are incarnations of gods with magical cures for various diseases. Right-wing groups like Sanatana Sanstha and the Hindu Jan Jagrati Samiti bitterly opposed the senior activist, labeling him anti-Hindu. Though the police still clueless who murdered Dabholkar, the Maharashtra government indirectly pointing fingers at right-wing groups.
गांधी जी की आवाज जिस तरह से बंद की गई, उसी तरह से डॉक्टर नरेंद्र दाभोलकर का विचार, उनके विचारों की ताकत, जो ताकतें नहीं सहन कर सकी, उन ताकतों ने उनकी निगरुण हत्या की है.
The biggest obstacle is clearly defining and spelling out the difference between faith and blind faith. Though Dr. Dabholkar always insisted he was not against any religion, but for some, the lines are just too blurred. Blurred enough for someone to just go out and kill a man. With Meloni Bhatt in Mumbai, Imtiaz Jaleel for NDTV.